What's going on, y'all? Welcome to another video. So just wanted to do this quick little video, get some stuff off my mind, just talk to y'all, let y'all know my thoughts. Today did not go as planned, as you can see by the thumbnail. And I don't know, it kind of got to me. I try to do better about, you know, not letting stuff get to me, but sometimes stuff does get to me and I do struggle with that sometimes. And just mentally, you know, these mental struggles that I have, you know, I suffer pretty bad from anxiety, depression. So I don't know, just want to let y'all know what happened anyways. And what do y'all think about the setup? Let me know what you think about the setup. I'm changing up everything in the room. I'm going for more of a minimalist type look. And I like it. It's really coming together. My wife helped me out. And yeah, so let me know. I could do a full tour, just let y'all know just what I use to run my business, my computer specs. Just going over my YouTube studio or home office. So if that's something y'all want to see, let me know in the comments down below. Let's get into the story. So me and my wife were doing a branding shoot today. We were trying to get some content and just update our branding photos. We haven't done it in a while. And I usually bring the wagon with me because y'all know we shoot off camera flash, and we were doing that today, but I chose not to bring it today for whatever reason. And yeah, which is probably why this happened. So I was carrying a lot of stuff. So I had my lights, I had the 400 Pro, and I had my kind of more so heavy duty tripod, the newer Pro stand. So, you know, it's not really a light setup, plus the 42 inch glow softbox. But we were going to our location, we're walking, and the base of the tripod hit something that was in the ground, and I freaking tripped. My freaking luck, I fell freaking flat. And I held on to my camera. I think something came over me and was like, hold on to the camera, do not drop the camera and let the camera go flying. So I really believe something came over me. I held on to the camera, but the freaking tripod, the light, all that stuff just went flying. Yeah, so I ended up breaking some of my gear. I could show y'all. I didn't break my camera, luckily, but I chipped it. And yeah, this freaking bothers me, man, because I really take care of my gear. And, you know, when it comes to like selling it and stuff like that, I don't know. This, I know it's little, it could have been worse. And I'm always one of those people, you know, things could be worse, but this bothers me. I'm not even gonna lie to y'all. So I chipped this, y'all see that right there. And I smashed my trigger, the X Pro S. So that's done. And also my 400 Pro, which y'all know is one of my favorite strobes. You can see the light is, the bulb is cracked. So it still works. So y'all can see it still works, but the freaking bulb, we're gonna have to get another bulb. I don't even know, maybe I could even still use it like this, but I just wanna get it fixed because I don't know, that could hurt somebody or something like that. So I freaking messed up a lot of my camera. Oh, I didn't even mention my freaking 85. I'm trying not to cuss because YouTube, I don't want to get demonetized or nothing like that, but my lens cap is cracked. I don't know if y'all could see that. And this little part, I don't know, but this little ring that goes in here, this comes out. So it like popped out. And it was like a little spot on the actual glass, but we wiped it off and most of it came off, but you could still see like just a little spot on it, I guess where it hit the ground. So it just didn't go as planned. And, you know, that's why I wanted to get on here and talk to y'all and just let y'all know about, you know, stuff isn't always going to go as planned. I even think if you think like, you know, you go into all this stuff, just whatever you're doing, just life. These are life lessons, you know, what I'm going to be telling y'all. But if you go in with the mindset of just expecting everything to be perfect, life, anything that you do, and just I don't know, I just think it's the wrong mindset to have, because stuff is going to happen, you know, in life. And it's all about how do you react to these situations, because I feel like we're in control of our feelings, our reactions, and we need to learn just how to control how we respond to certain stuff. You know, I was pretty mad about this. Like, I kind of laid on the ground for a second. My wife was like, oh my God, are you okay? Her friend tagged along too. She was probably like, what the heck just happened? And I was mad. I was even saying in my head, forget this shoot, let's just go home. That's what I wanted to do. But, you know, I snapped out of it. I'm like, we're going to push through. And we actually got some dope shots. So I'm really glad that I pushed through. And that's a big deal for me, because I'm real big on just stuff going as planned. So when that happened, it just threw everything off. And this was at the beginning of the shoot. Like, we hadn't even started shooting yet. So it just completely killed my vibe. I don't know if y'all can relate, but, you know, sometimes things happen and it just kills your vibe. You know, even like with YouTube, sometimes maybe something happened and I just don't want to record because it just killed my vibe and it makes it hard to push forward. And, you know, for some people that may be easy, but for me, it's definitely something that I struggle with. I know it's something that other people struggle with sometimes, just when things don't go right. And just, you know, how do you respond to that? How do you move forward? Can you move forward? And just like pushing through that specific situation and not letting your emotions get the best of you, and just, you know, really bringing yourself down, because that's something also that, you know, is a battle with me of, you know, getting in my own head and just letting stuff just bring me down. And it could be the littlest thing. Yeah, sometimes stuff really gets to me. You know, I'm not going to sit up here and act like it doesn't, because it really does. So yeah, that's what happened. But luckily we have insurance, which is something else I wanted to talk about. We do have gear insurance with PPA, Professional Photographers Association. So we're going to call them tomorrow and see if we could get some of this stuff, if they could help us with some of this stuff. I don't even know if they're going to help us, because technically, I don't know if anything is well, besides the trigger, because the light still works. I don't know how it's going to work with the cracked bulb. The lens, I don't know, maybe something internally messed up, or the camera. We still got to play around with that and make sure it's not messing up, because it could be something messed up in the inside. But like I was saying, that's something that I wanted to mention. You need insurance. You never know what's going to happen. So you may think things aren't going to happen, or, you know, something like damaging your gear, or just something, some crazy unforeseen situation. You know, we don't really think about that stuff. We just think about the good and the good that's going to come out of stuff. But stuff like this can happen. You know, I've broke my 8200 before. You're going to break gear. So it's really important that you get insurance to cover you just in case something happens, and also have backup gear. And that's what I was telling my wife when this happened. Like, I was like, you see why it's so important to have backup gear, because you never know what's going to happen. And, you know, this could have been a lot worse. We could have had some shoots, a whole bunch of shoots lined up. We could have had a shoot lined up tomorrow. And, you know, maybe my main camera broke and that's the only camera that I have, or my light. And now I'm kind of stuck out. So, you know, that's just something to think about within your business and in photography, is to just be prepared for anything. You know, set yourself up from the get-go so you won't be stressed out later on. You know what I mean? Because this could have been a lot worse. And, you know, I understand that. And that's kind of why I snapped out of it, because I was like, this could have been worse. I could have broke my wrist because I fell freaking hard. I could have broke my arm, anything, you know. And I always try. It's hard sometimes, but I try to look at situations like that. Like, you know what? It could be worse. Just push forward and keep doing what you got to do. So yeah, that's what happened. Could have been a lot worse, but, you know, I'm glad it wasn't a lot worse. But just want to share that with y'all. You know, sometimes I just have thoughts and I want to share them, you know, with the people that follow me. You know, it helps. I talked to my wife about stuff and she was saying she was proud of me that I pushed through, because she knows how I am, and I can let stuff really get me in a slump and really get me down to where I don't want to do nothing. And I just kind of, you know, just kind of not quit, but just kind of throw in a towel with whatever I'm doing in that moment. So yeah, y'all be careful out here. If you shoot off camera flash, make sure you bring your wagon. Don't be trying to be Superman and just carrying everything. You know, just slow down, pay attention, take care of your gear, prepare yourself, get your insurance, make sure you're pricing yourself accordingly, so that you can have money in case something like this happens and you're not stressed out. Anyways, on another note, I did get some BTS of the shots we did after that with Kimbo. And I was kind of like giving y'all some tips of just, you know, shooting outside with off camera flash and just lighting and locations and tips like that. So hopefully I'll be uploading that soon. I got to check it on a computer and see how that footage looks. So pretty excited about that. But thanks for listening to my little talk. Hopefully you took something away from this video. And let me know if you've ever had any situation where you freak accident and you broke, I don't know, your favorite camera gear or anything. Let me know in the comment section, so, you know, we can just all share our experiences and just laugh at it. You know, that's what I did later on. I just freaking laughed at it. My wife laughed at it. We were just talking about it about 30 minutes ago, and we were just laughing at it because it could have been a lot worse. And she was laughing about how I fell, and she said I fell flat. So sometimes I just think it's best just to laugh at stuff and just move on after that instead of being mad and being sad and stuff like that. So yeah, thanks for listening. Make sure you drop the like and subscribe to my channel. I post new videos every single week. I will see y'all in my next video. Peace.